Hello friends, now we are going to discuss the topic standards or standardization. Okay, standardization is very crucial from the design point of view. So first we will see what is standardization. Standardization is a something called as compulsory or a obligatory norms. Norms are a rules. Norms, we can say rules. This is a compulsory norm or a rule to which various characteristics of product should conform. Product may have different characteristics. A different product may have different characteristics. We will see that characteristics one by one. So whatever may be the characteristic, that characteristic should conform to the some compulsory rules. That characteristic should conform to the some compulsory, or we can say obligatory rules or obligatory norms. That is called a standardization. I will give you one example. Suppose you want to use a pump, a centrifugal pump in your machine. So you will search in market what are the standard sizes, standard capacities. I am using word standards every time. Okay, so you will search in market what are the standard sizes of pump available, and you will choose one of the standard size available in market. You will not manufacture your own pump. Okay, because a standard product which is available in market is very relatively very cheap as compared to designing your own product and then manufacturing our own product. There are different advantages of using a standard product which is readily available. You just go in market, purchase it and use in your machine. Whatever you are designing, you can design and then use that standard product in your machine or a system, whatever you are designing. So this is an example of a standard product. Or you can take any other example. You are going to use many couplings. You are going to use a bearing. Bearing is also one of the good example of a standardization. Bearings. You can design your own bearing and you can manufacture, but the cost or the machine required for that production is very costly. And if this bearing fails, then you have to replace. Then for replacement, there is no product available in market because you have designed something new. So each time you want to replace, you have to manufacture your own bearing. So this is a very good advantage of standardization, that you can easily change. If your product is failed, you just go to market, buy the same product and just replace it. So standardization gives the advantage of interchangeability. There are products available, go purchase it and replace it very easy. No need to manufacture it. So this is all possible because of standardization. So standardization is a compulsory norm to which various characteristics of product should conform. So this characteristic may be materials. There are some standards for materials. There are standards for dimensions and shape of the component. There are standards for testing. Standard for testing, it is also called as code. We are going to see this. Standard for testing, it is called as code. Then there are some standards for packing, storing, how to store a particular product. There are standards. If that product is stored and packed according to the standard, then this product will not get damaged. Okay, so this is a different examples of standards. See, first one is a material, standards for materials. I'm just discussing few examples. Standards for materials, their chemical compositions, their mechanical properties and heat treatment. This is a one standard. An example of such a standardization is FG150. FG150 is a gray cast iron. Gray cast iron. This is a standard gray cast iron, which indicates this is denoted by FG150, and 150, this 150 is its ultimate tensile strength. Ultimate tensile strength. So if you want a material which is having tensile strength of 150 newton per millimeter square, then you can go for FG150, and you purchase that FG150 gray cast iron from market. But if you require a tensile strength of 200 MPa, then you have to go for FG200. If you require more strength, then you can go for FG220. So what standardization has done, it has reduced the range available, okay, but at the same time it has also reduced the cost, because making a one product in a mass scale reduces the cost, that we all know that. So if someone is manufacturing a FG150 cast iron, producing a FG150 in a large scale, then the cost will be low. Suppose you need a 160, then what will you do? You will go for higher side, directly you will go for FG200. Okay, so this will reduce the cost of producing that material. There are some standards which also controls the chemical composition. Okay, suppose this is a plain carbon steel, 40C8. This is a plain carbon steel. Okay, in this plain carbon steel, 0.04% carbon is there. So if you want a plain carbon steel which is having particular properties, particular chemical composition, you directly go for that standard product available in market and take that. Okay, this is one example. Now, standards for shape, dimension and for a commonly used machine element. As I already told you, one example is ball bearing, but there are some other examples also. Belts are also available in standard size. You don't need to manufacture your own belt in any arbitrary size and dimensions. Also, it is standards available for chains, rivets, screws, nuts, bolts, wire ropes, keys. These are different machine elements which are commonly used in a design of a machine, in manufacturing of a machine. These are available in standard sizes. So what will happen if suppose in my system I need a 10, suppose I need a 100 products, say I need 100 different components in my design, in a manufacturing system, okay, in a system or a product, in a machine, suppose there are 100 different parts, and out of these 100 parts, say 30 parts are standard parts. So what will happen, I will directly purchase this 30 part from the market. I will select whichever best for me, but I will not design, I will not manufacture. I will directly purchase this 30 parts. So now only remaining 70 parts will be manufactured in my manufacturing plant. So this reduces the time, also reduces the cost. So this is another advantage of standardization. And next is a standards for testing of product. Suppose I want to test a boiler. Boiler is very crucial in a thermal power plant or in some other food industries. So for testing, some fixed procedure is set by the different associations, different organizations. If you follow that procedure, then the testing will be correct. Okay, so what will happen by setting a particular procedure, if a different person is testing, then there will be no change in the output. Output will be similar because procedure is standardized. Say, take example of a tensile test. In tensile test, you might have performed an experiment on a universal testing machine for a tension test. You have taken a steel bar and then hold that bar in a clamp in a universal testing machine, then apply the force, then at some particular stress level that bar breaks or yields. So there is a standard procedure for testing of a tension test or a testing a bar. So by using a standard procedure, what will happen? Then test result will be uniform. There will not be any arbitrary results in the testing. So this testing or standards for testing is also called as codes. Okay, this is also called codes. And this is a few example: testing of a pressure vessel, boiler, crane, wire, rope, etc. So this also ensures the safety because it is tested safety. This ensures the safety. Then there are standards for engineering drawing and components. You have studied engineering drawing in first year, so you have been taught that the letter size should be this much, the orthographic projection should be like this, the isometric projection should be like that. So everything is fixed in a standard. So if one student draws a orthographic projections and some other student draws the orthographic projection of same product, and a third student draws the orthographic projection of a same product, then all the students, if follows these norms or follows the standards, then drawing will be same. If n number of students draws the drawing, then result will be same because there is a standard and you have to follow that standard. So results will be similar, and this standard drawing can be easily read by this person can read this person can read this, because you know that if part is not visible, you use a dotted line. This is a standard. So anyone who knows the engineering drawing can read it easily because you have used a standard there. This is the benefit of standard. Now there is a bit of difference in a standard and a code. Standards are generally used for different parts, materials and process. This is used for different parts, materials and process. And why this is used? To reduce the variety, to confine it to some range, say 10, 20, okay, to a reasonable level, to confine it to a reasonable level. This is the purpose. And code is generally for analysis, design, manufacture, testing, erection. Suppose I want to erect a turbine in a power plant, then there is a standard procedure. That procedure is a code, how to erect a turbine in a power plant. If I follow the standard code, then the installation will be correct and it is very easy to understand to other user of that product. So, and this is generally used to attain a level of safety, a specified level of safety. The primary concern in code is a safety, whereas in this we want to reduce the cost, we want to reduce the time, so for that we use a standard. See, there are three types of standards. First one is a company standard. Obviously you can clearly understand that if a standard used in a particular company, say suppose I take example of a Tata Motors. If Tata Motors has created some standard for some particular product, then it will be used in that company only. So this is called as a company standard. If it is used in a particular company or a group of companies, then it is a company standard. If it is used in a throughout the nation, a standard created by some national organization for that particular country, then this is a national standard. This is a Indian standard. Example of that is Indian standard. Bureau of Indian Standards prepares the different standard rules for different products, say drawings, say procedure. So this is used throughout this country, throughout the boundary of this country. This is one example. Such standards are also used in other countries also. Say BS. BS is a British standard. It is used in Britain. Likewise, there are some standards for Germany, USA. So likewise, these are the national standards that are used in that countries. And last one is international standards. It is prepared by organizations such as ISO, International Standards Organization. This is one example. There are some environmental organizations that create standards for environment. There are some standards for related to forest, related to mining, related to human rights. So different organizations create different standards for international use. These standards are used throughout the globe. This is all about the types. Now, throughout the discussion, we have seen different advantages. We will just go through this. The first advantage is reduction in types. Say, take example of a cast iron. Cast iron is available for tensile stress of Fg 150. I have taken this example 150. Then there is directly 200. Then 220. Likewise. So a manufacturer only needs to manufacture three type. He don't have to produce all the types, say from 150, 151, 152. He don't need to produce the cast gray cast iron of all the tensile strength. He will only produce three types of cast iron. For I am just taking example. There are many beyond this 220 tensile strength. So just for the example, he will produce for three tensile strength only, and the user will select one of these three. If 150 is fine, then he will take 150. If he requires more strength, then he will go for 200, or again more strength is required, then he will go for 220. But this reduces the variation, this reduces the types. Also, dimensions of identical component to rational number. Say example of bearing is available in standard diameters 10, 20, 25, 30, likewise. So this reduces the variation also. Reduce the manufacturing facility, because standard product available easily. I can directly go and purchase this, though no need to manufacture. So in my own manufacturing plant, I will require less machine, less manpower. So this is also one of the advantage. Standard parts are easy to replace, that we have seen already. So it is an advantage of interchangeability. It reduces the time and effort needed to design, because I don't need to design a bearing, don't need to design a pump, don't need to design an electrical motor. So it will reduce the designing time. Okay, I will use that standard part and I will only design the rest of part. Also then standards of specification and testing procedure of machine element improve the quality and reliability. If I know that this is a product which is tested by a standard code, then I will feel very safe to use that product. You might have seen, you see different logos on the product, say ISO mark. Okay, so likewise, if that is marked on that product, the customer will feel safe. So these are the advantages of standardization. Thank you.